Hey, hello, and welcome back. This is the Ultimate Ladybug Course video number 27, and we are almost at the finish line. There's just a few things to look at and consider, and a few quite important tools we need to cover. And in the last video, we need to cover. And then we are pretty much done. Now, in the last video, we looked at how we can improve our visual output. We looked at color ranges, spatial heat maps, and how we can output views and how we can arrange objects to the camera and so on. In this video, this will be a bit shorter, short and sweet, and we will look at something nobody has talked about yet, I think, in any tutorial, but conversions. Well, we live in a world where there's not just meters, there is also miles and feet, and that's why there needs to be conversions. And instead of like setting up your Rhino in a certain way, you can actually convert within Grasshopper to whatever you want. And you could do that at the end of your analysis to convert everything in whatever you want and whatever you need. Probably the best option. Otherwise, it's getting messy. But let's have a look at that. All right. As you can see, I completely cleaned out my old model because this few videos will be a bit more abstract and less about the models itself. I'll still put here like an Arctic view, it's nicer. All right, so for this video, we actually don't need Rhino. We only need Ladybug. Now we are here. In the last video, we looked at this section from the Ladybug color range to Ladybug set view. That was the range we looked at. Oh, that was the tools we looked at. Today, we will look at these tools here. LB to IP. What does it mean? LB to SI. LB to unit and LB unit converter. All right, so let's have a look. Ladybug to imperial units, imperial values. So, for example, what could I take here? I could use the wind speeds. If I put the wind speeds in here, it turns gray, something happens, and we can have a look. So the wind speed were changed from meter per second, because here's a meter per second, to miles per hour. And to show this a bit better, we can take another panel here and we can use the deconstruct data set to make sure that we are not making any mistake here. So you can see here, wind speeds meter per second. And if I take this whole thing and put it in here, then I have the miles per hour. And of course, we can convert it back to metric units. So we went from metric units, meter per second, to miles per hour and back to meter per second. We can also look at, for example, the temperature. Let's have a look at temperature. Temperature data. So this was changed to Fahrenheit. So you can actually see here. Yeah. Dry bulb temperature is changed to Fahrenheit and then back to Celsius. And you could inform whole diagrams with, you know, converting your numbers and play that back into a spatial heat map and so on. So that's pretty neat. The L Ladybug to unit, this is a different animal. How does that work? So now, for example, I have relative humidity. Let's test it out. We can place the data here. And it says here, we input the data. Currently, we see dew point temperature. Should we try to have relative humidity? It's more fun. Let's see what we could do in percentage. There's probably not a lot of other units, but what you can see here is on what you can actually change it to. You have a few options actually here. So you could change it to fraction, tenths, thousandths, or octa. But let's stay with the dew point temperature. Maybe that's interesting here. You can change that to Fahrenheit and Kelvin. Now, how to do that? You just get a panel, disconnect all this here. Let's get rid of this. It's so confusing. Let's change this to Kelvin. Just place here K and we have Kelvin. Then we could just, you know, grab all this, copy and copy this, place this in here and put Fahrenheit. And everything has changed to Fahrenheit. What else can we do with conversions? LB unit converter. That's also interesting. If you, for example, have values, but you don't have a data set, because that also happens. You could have values coming out of a tool, which is not a data set, because data set has a header and has values. So actually, if you look at the panel again, do you see you have all these things here? You have what type of data it is, temperature, the unit in Celsius, and when, what is the period, the city, the country, time zone, and so on. But sometimes you only get the values. And what you can do is, if you know the values, for example, if you know the values are C, temperature, you can place here from C to, and then here, this is very handy. It's a list of units and types of data you can change things to. For example, temperature has only Celsius, Fahrenheit, and Kelvin, but we could, for example, what could we do here? Kilowatt hours per square meter. Okay, let's try this. We know, okay, we get some random values and we know, okay, it's kilowatt hours per square meter. So watt hours per square meter. So I just need to find this watt hours per square meter. That was per meter square. Okay. And then I can convert it to any of these. BTU to feet to, I'm wondering now if that works. BTU feet square. Typo. Yes, works. Okay. So that's the ultimate converter. Basically converts in any unit. Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Okay, that's about unit conversions. Relatively straightforward. Now, what about if we want to convert from, let's say, a data set of energy intensity to and total energy? So energy per unit rather than energy as a total, in total. Let's look at a few more advanced concepts in Ladybug. All right, let's jump right in. So we looked at changing from metric systems to imperial systems and back. We changed units, the type of units, and we only had values where we basically converted values into different outputs. For example, values in Celsius to Kelvin. You know, that's super useful as well. Now, and with the all units, all U, we can look at what are the types of data sets we can have and what units they use. Okay, that's quite straightforward. Now, there are a few more tools here. I will delete this, by the way. Don't want to see that. There are a few tools here which has a similar symbol. It's Ladybug Area Normalize, Ladybug Area Aggregate, Ladybug Time Rate of Change, and Ladybug Time Aggregate. All right, so to understand this, like in very simple terms, if I have a data set, an hourly data set, like for example, the diffuse horizontal radiation, or let's say, yeah, diffuse global horizontal radiation.
Let's do this.
The output here is watt hours per square meter, right? So if we want to look at the, and this is per square meter, you understand? So basically on one square meter, we have a certain value. We can have a look maybe if we deconstruct the data set here, then we can look at the values. I'll copy this panel and plug in the values here. You can see that's in the night, 0000, and then from 6 in the morning, it starts to gather some energy. Now, this is per square meter, right? This is energy intensity. Now, what if we want to calculate the total energy of the whole year for the whole site? And without losing the data set, so we're converting data sets, and we're not converting values, we're converting data sets. So in that case, the data set is a header and values. In that case, we can use the aggregate data. So we put here the data set with the square meter, and we can put the area of the plot. We can put the total area. So without having any building, we could, for example, if we create a solar panel park, we create a park, it's only solar panel, but there's no shading. That would be the best kind of application for it. So we can see what is the total energy for the whole year. Now, if for example, I have a site, don't worry about this building, don't worry about what's in here. This is the incident radiation. We calculate it here. But let's get just the area of that face. So I have, this is my site. Maybe I can turn this off so it's not confusing. This is the area in here. And I just added a native grasshopper area calculation to get here. And that's the area I'm using. I'm gonna put this in here. And now it turns gray. And I can put here the unit, which is by default is square meter. It could be either square meter or square feet, depending on your model. And the data output now is not watt hours per square meter. It's only watt hours based on the whole area. So for every day, it's just calculating the total energy for the whole site. And if I want to look at this as a data, as values, I can go in here, copy this, and I can see the values here. This is then per site. The area here is about, what's the area? And see, it's about almost 600 square meter. 600 square meter, forget the building, imagine the building is not there. That's the total energy per day. And then I could, of course, use a mass addition here to just calculate the entire energy, all right? Okay, now there's also the reversed option. You can basically just take the data which is aggregated into, so for example, you only have the aggregated data set. You only have the total amount per day. Then you could, if you want to compare two sites, for example, one is larger or smaller, you want to normalize it to, let's say, one square meter. That means, okay, going back here, I can go put here the data. This is my data set. The area is this here. And the output now is, and units again is by default is square meter. Or square feet is again the same. So in case you have only the total energy per site and you want to get, you want to get like a normalized version where you can compare it with another site which is smaller or larger, then you could use this tool to compare it. Now if we look into here, so that should be, let's check it out, should be the same as before. Yes, so we were able to convert it back to what it was before. Pretty neat. Okay, so then you can go back with this kit to, for example, if you have a data set not from the Ladybug weather data, or from the, sorry, E plus weather data, then you could create your own data set. That's that. Now there are two more tools you can play around, which is the Ladybug time rate of change and the Ladybug time aggregate. Now, as you can see here, what the output here, again, let's go back, pedal. So first we aggregate the area. So it turns into the total energy. We can go from energy to power by aggregating the time. So I can go in here, and this gives me the power, the watt, only watt. And if I want to do the opposite direction, then I can go back here and put this in here, and we get back the kilowatt hours. So we go from watt to kilowatt hours. We have to be careful here because that might not be the right thing. Wait, let's check. No, that's, I think it's correct. Yes. That's also possible, by the way, if we put this in here. If we go from watt hours per square meter, it removes the time aspect of it, becomes watt per square meter, the energy flux. And by aggregating time, we can go back from watt to kilowatt per hour square meter, which is supposed to be the same as here. So if I go here, okay, now this is watt hours per square meter. Now let's compare these and see if it works.
the way it should?
Yes.
Kilowatt. In that case, it's kilowatt hours. So if we go here, electricity, we have to be careful. Sorry, we have to be very careful because what we did here is to generate the total for the whole site. That means the kilowatt hours is for the whole site, not for the individual square meter. That needs to be clear. So by normalizing it back, of course, this shrinks because it's all normalized to one square meter. So I hope it's clear. It's a bit tricky to understand. If you don't understand, ask ChatGPT. Just, you know, you can send me a message, but, you know, try it first. It's not so difficult. If you get the hang of it, it's not very difficult. All right, that is unit conversions. Pretty interesting stuff. Something that isn't, I'm 100% sure, there is no other tutorial in this YouTube or anywhere on the planet. Maybe in the forum and maybe in the paid course, but not for free. All right, see you in the next video.